Before we get started, does anyone want to get out?
All right, everybody, welcome into A Reel and a Beer. It's trailer reaction time. My most anticipated movie of the summer is got trailer number two, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. We are super, super excited for this one. Never been excited to get off work more in my life to get home than to do this trailer reaction right here. The first one absolutely killed. I expect the second one to. And as always, let's walk, not talk.
I'm Rick Dalton. It's my pleasure. And Mr. Schwartz,
I'm in my dream.
Gino, dude.
What's your son?
No, it's my stunt double, Cliff Booth.
Last night, we backstage Rick Dalton double feature on the shooting.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
I love that stuff, you know, the killing.
A lot of killing.
Everybody order fried sauerkraut!
Fried sauerkraut. That's awesome, dude. Yes! More, please. Yes! Right on time. I gotta perfect that shit, bro.
No, I'm
still
man.
So he's still
in
the wreck, huh?
Oh! Damn!
I heard you can be an actor, Rick. Not a TV cowboy.
Yes.
You're better than that. Dwan?
Oh, shit.
You yourself like that in front of all the goddamn people!
Oh, shit, bro.
All right, what's the matter, partner?
It's official, old buddy. Well, it has been.
Oh, shit.
Different tone from the first one.
Oh, hell yeah. Totally.
Here I am, flat on my ass. Who do I got living next door to me?
I'm Sharon Tate. I'm in the movie.
Oh, my God.
That's me. I play Miss Carlson, the Klutz.
Oh. Natural beauty. Yes, bro.
Charlie's gonna
take him. And the gospel group. Telling
you why.
In this town,
bro,
I can all change. Okay.
You're Rick fucking Dalton. Don't you forget it.
Hell yeah.
I'm using that.
Okay, man. Totally different vibe than the first one. I'm digging it. We see a lot more of their interaction, what's actually happening. And there towards the end, they said, in this town, you know, anything can happen. I guess that's a hint to the Charlie Manson stuff that they're intertwining in this. Mm-hmm. I'm stoked. I'm in 110 still. Want to see it even more. Bringing in Russell, Pacino. This is going to be star-studded, fantastic. But what I like about it most is, if you got the balls, and I'm going to say balls, to make a movie about Hollywood, you better have some true actors. This is going to be one of those movies where the acting carries it. Not the CGI, not the effects. This is going to be... the writing and the actual pure acting is going to carry this movie. Leonardo DiCaprio has to act like he can't act in a scene. That's going to be fantastic. If anything's been fantastic, that's going to be fantastic. My man Jay, what you got for me?
This movie has been like, I've been looking forward to it for a long time, ever since they dropped the cast of it. Mm-hmm. Because you got Leonardo, Brad Pitt. Brad Pitt's OG, man. He's like one of my favorites.
He is.
You got Margaret Robbie. You got Al Pacino, Kurt Russell. You got all those guys. And now you got an all-star cast in one movie. And about Hollywood, like you said, it's going to be phenomenal. I feel like we're going to go and we're going to leave all our minds blown.
I think so.
Like, you know, like, because this right here is a different vibe. You know, I like this chill vibe, you know, type of movie back in the 60s and stuff like that. So, I'm really looking forward to it. I think it's going to be a masterpiece. And
it's got that freelance, free-filling, pot-headed...
Yeah.
What's the Woodstock type vibe?
Yeah, exactly. So, I'm looking forward to it. And all let's right, just man. Get it on. Let's Hang go. On.
What you got for me, Josh?
All right. Timothy Oliphant. Luke Perry. I think this is a
Luke Perry. Hell yeah, dude. Yeah. Luke Perry's in it, too.
So, Tarantino is one of my favorite directors of all time. Love everything he has put out. This will be the ninth. But the thing that, and I've told you this before, the thing that I love about Tarantino is what I like to call the nothing conversation. We've seen it in Reservoir Dogs, where they're talking about tipping. There's scenes in Pulp Fiction. There's scenes in Kill Bill, Inglourious Bastards, that have nothing to do with it, but they have these deep conversations, and it seems so natural. It's just crazy. But, wow. Okay, Inglourious Bastards. I love that movie, and it was kind of Tarantino's way of saying, this is how I would have liked for World War II to have ended.
the Nazis.
So, we all know how the Charles Manson story went down, and with Sharon Tate, she was murdered. And I think he did his take on what he would have liked to have seen in World War II. I think we're going to see Brad Pitt take down Charles Manson before he gets to Sharon Tate. Which is an interesting take on it. Tarantino kind of takes true stories and turns them on their head to how he would have liked for them to have happened.
Makes sense if they go that route.
I thought the scene with the Leo burning up the Nazis was kind of a shout out to Inglourious Bastards.
Who wants
the
movie fried theater. Sauerkraut? Is that what he said? Yeah. Roasted sauerkraut.
He said, you can take your Wiener Schnitzel licking finger and point out on his map if you ever want to eat another sauerkraut sandwich.
It's awesome.
I love it. Can't wait. So excited. There's been a few big productions that have let us down. I'm not going to say any names. So to see something like this come along that I think will live up to the hype, I think this will live up to the hype.
Do you think this film, with the disappointment in not only blockbusters but television, not saying no names, two major things that have disappointed at least half of America, do you think this film could be that diamond in the rough that makes the summer, you're like, you know what, we had some letdowns, but that was the genuine, just stellar movie that I'm okay with it all?
For me, I'm a Tarantino first night kind of guy.
Oh, hell yeah.
So, I don't know just how much of America is, but I think they will see in this. But yeah,
I think there's a lot of people going to not see this because of some of his other work. Because Tarantino's an acquired taste. If you're in, you're in. If you're on the fence, usually you're out with him. I love his work. You love his work. Mm-hmm. Not everybody shares that view like us, but I think the people who don't give this a chance is going to be kicking themselves in the ass later for not doing it.
If it doesn't just kill in the theaters, I think it'll kill in DVRs.
Wherever it goes.
Yeah. It's.
I think it's going to do a little something, though.
I think so. I mean,
I don't see why it wouldn't. I mean, look at the cast. The cast says it all. Oh my goodness. You know what I mean? So
Christopher Walken.
God, he's in it too.
I know. I mean,
damn, I forgot he's even in it.
God, it's huge.
Luke Perry too, man. Damn.
I know.
I'm Jack, bro. I'm an 11 out of 10. I'm an 11 out of 10.
And here's the thing. Quentin Tarantino is the guy, if you want a true glimpse into Hollywood, because on the surface, kind of like with the first trailer, glitz and glamour, but we've seen it take a darker turn, and that's how Hollywood is when you get in there and you start peeling away some of the layers.
It can eat you up and spit you out.
Sure can.
Even big stars, man.
Yeah.
What's the guy, if you don't believe that, case in point, what's the guy that played in Pearl Harbor, the other guy in Pearl Harbor?
Josh.
Yeah. Where's he? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Somebody like him, promising star, neck and neck with Affleck in that movie. Now, boom.
Yeah.
He's been eat up and spit out by Hollywood. That's the case in point. You're right. I don't. You got anything else?
That's it, man.
No, I'm good.
This one right here, I'm going to say this before I go off. This is my most anticipated movie of the summer. I don't see how it couldn't hit I have nothing but positive things. It's literally an 11 out of 10 for me to see.
Is Godzilla considered a summer film?
Yeah, it is. Godzilla's up there.
I don't think Godzilla's going to be hitting like this is, though. Godzilla's going to be good.
I think Godzilla's going to be a good movie. I think it's going to be more along with what we're so used to with a popcorn film.
Yeah,
popcorn. Give me my soda. Let me eat this and watch the CGI and be blown away.
This is real.
This is going to be acting with that, and writing and just, whoa.
With that being said, I'm a huge MCU Batman Superman. I love comic book movies.
I do too.
But ever so often, it's good to go back to your roots.
Breath of fresh air.
Nothing against CGI. I love CGI.
I do too.
But to see a movie that is going to rely on its acting.
Like I said, you gotta.
And it's directing. I'm really excited.
Writing, directing, and acting.
Yep.
Like I said, we got DiCaprio having to act like he don't know how to act. That's acting upon act. That's three layers deep.
That's like
acting.
Breaking the fifth wall.
Yeah. I mean, that's like Matrix type shit right there. All right, guys. We're going to shut this one down. If you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button. Hit the bell for the notifications to get all of our new material as soon as it drops. This is Once Upon a Hollywood trailer number 2.
Once Upon a Time in Hollywood.
Once Upon a Time in Hollywood trailer number 2. We are out.